We would work with about a third of the school population, and we see a huge amount of talent and entrepreneurship with them. And really what we were aiming to do with the Make-A-Wish campaign is to transfer all of that enthusiasm and passion that we see in the young people and make the MLAs aware that there is a huge amount of talent out there. There's a lot of young people interested in having a positive future, and we just wanted to let their voice be heard. I think the range of the wishes surprised us. We kind of thought they would be centred mostly on education or in jobs, but they went across probably all of the departments, really looking from a very personal viewpoint right through to the wider economy.
I came along to, support all these wishes and stuff, and to show support for the school as well.
We thought that it would be a good opportunity to put our views across to the politicians.
But can you improve rural transport links to the northwest? That's quite a big thing, but I'd be bringing that up with my colleague Danny Kennedy, who's the Minister for Transport.
A couple of the wishes they did look at were really concerned about the jobs and the impact of the economy and the recession. So, I mean, there's obviously an awful lot of them here. I mean, we've got issues like integrated schools coming up, you know, votes at 16. There's a fair few various issues.
On balance, we're probably for voting at 16, even though it puts a lot of pressure on people, because at 16 you're maybe not sure exactly what way you're going to think in the future. But we take the view that the earlier people get used to voting, the better. Because the trouble is, if you vote at 18 and then you go to college or university, you go away, you don't get into the habit of it, and then, the whole democracy thing falls down a wee bit.
A significant proportion of our vote already comes from younger people. I mean, we had, for example, the votes at 16 motion, which was tabled here in the Assembly and voted on the debate, and that was a Green Party motion, which was brought to the agenda. And we think that, giving younger people a voice in terms of, for example, lowering the voting age would be beneficial. And it'll also show that we are listening to younger people and we're listening to their concerns.
What we want to do is, off the back of this launch, is actually have an event in the new year where we get the MLAs and the young people to engage and have a positive dialogue about the future and the economy and what needs to be done to build a good infrastructure for them. So it may not always be the Christmas tree, but we'll look at how we really increase having the young person's voice heard by local politicians.